Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 3.3, Problem 3. This is Section 3.3, Problem number 3. It says, consider the data 33, 55, 90, 71, 8, 96, 27, 48, 22, 44, and 60. Find the five number summary, find the interquartile range, and draw the box plot. So for the five number summary, what we have to do is find the smallest data value, Q1, Q2, Q3, and the biggest. So to do that, let me first put the list of data in order. That's important. You can't just start finding the middle of the list and whatnot until it's in order. Right now it's just in a random order. So in order, let's see, it looks like my smallest one is 8. I like to cross them off as I use them. As I look next, I look for things in the teens, nothing in the teens. In the 20s, I seem to have 2. 22 will come next. And then 27, nothing else in the 20s. So I'll look for 30s next. I think I only have one entry in the 30s, like that. I'll look for 40s next. Seems that I have 2, 44, and 48. And in the 50s, it seems to be only one. It's 55. In the 60s, I have a value of 60. And then in the 70s, I don't think I have any. 71. There we go. In the 80s, I don't have any. And then two in the 90s, I have 90 and 96. So let's just count. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 data values in my question. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So that's a good sign. In general, when you want to rank your data like this, put it in order, it's not a bad idea to leave a little bit of a space in case you miss one so you can sneak a number in between without starting your whole list again or making too much of a mess out of it. So getting back to my smallest, Q1, Q2, Q3, biggest. Once it's in order, the smallest and the biggest are easy. 8 is the smallest data value. The biggest is 96. Now, for the quartiles, you actually have to find Q2 first. You can't find Q1 first. So Q2 is the median, or 50th percentile. Now, where I have 11 data values, 11 numbers in my list, that's an odd amount. There'll be one value right in the middle, which for this problem is 48. There are five values that are smaller, or to the left, five values that are larger, or to the right. 48 is right in the middle. That makes it the 50th percentile, which makes it Q2. Now we can find Q1. Q1 is the median of the smaller half of the data, not including Q2. So the smaller half of the data, not including Q2, would be 8, 22, 27, 33, and 44. There are five data values there. Five's odd. There's one value right in the middle, which would be 27. That's Q1. And then the answer for Q3 is the median of the upper half of the data, not including Q2. So it'd be the bigger five values, in this case 55, 60, 71, 90, and 96. Again, five values, it's an odd amount of data. There's going to be one value right in the middle, which is 71. So that's Q3. So there's my five number summary. Next, the interquartile range. That's simply Q3 minus Q1. That's the interquartile range. So for this problem, Q3 is 71 minus Q1, which is 27. And if I subtract that, it comes out to 44. So the interquartile range is 44. And part C, draw the box plot. So a box plot can be drawn horizontally or vertically. And basically what you're going to do is have a number scale. You're going to have a box. And the parts of the box occur at the different heights of the number scale. You have your smallest, Q1, Q2, Q3, and the biggest. Again, Q1 is the bottom edge of the box, Q2 is the line in the box, Q3 is the top edge of the box, and it can go side to side. So for this particular problem, the biggest number that I have to put into my drawing is 96. I definitely don't want to make 96 of the lines. So going by 10s is a good choice. 10 lines will get me up to 100. And you can do horizontal or vertical. I can make it vertical. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And I'll label that as 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100. So, you can draw it in whatever order you want. I like to draw the top and bottom of the box first. So Q1 is the bottom edge of the box. So for this problem, Q1 is 27. I don't have 27 exactly on my number scale, so I'll find the 30, which is close, and go a little bit lower. So that'll be the bottom of the box. Q3 is the top edge of the box. For this problem, Q3 is 71. Again, I don't have exactly a 71 on my scale, so I'll find 70, which is close, and go a tiny bit higher. And I'll connect those, and I'll make it wide enough the box looks pretty close to square. Now, there's a line inside the box for Q2, not necessarily right in the center, could be in the center. So Q2 for this problem is 48. Again, my number scale, I don't have exactly a 48, so I'll find 50, which is close, go a little lower. It looks like about a height of 48, that'll be my Q2. And then your lines come out of the top and bottom of the box to the smallest and biggest data value. So coming out of the bottom of the box, I'm going to go down to 8, and you can come out of the center. Again, I don't have an 8 on my number scale, so I want to go down a little tiny bit lower than the 10. My biggest data value is a 96, and like the other numbers, I don't have exactly a 96 on my scale. Figure 95 is just halfway between the 90 and the 100, so I'll bring that over. I'll go a tiny, tiny bit higher for 96. And come from the center of the box up to what I feel is a height of 96. And that's the box plot.